Hey, how are you doing? Today I'm going to show you how I disassemble and clean and repaste the processor in this Xbox Series X console. So first things first, I start by removing a couple of screws on the back. They are hidden under these sneaky little covers, but that's where some good old isopropyl alcohol comes in handy. Now, the second screw is even more hidden, but if you shimmy your finger around, you will feel a small indent. I just use my screwdriver to unscrew it from there. Sure, I could have removed the whole plastic wrap and done it the proper way, but the owner was cool with me going this route. Quick tip before we get too far, all the screws in this Xbox are Torx 8. So make sure you've got the right screwdriver handy. Once those screws are out, I grab a plastic spudger to pry open the back of the console. Let me tell you, this thing has collected some serious dust over the years. Honestly, it looks like it hasn't been cleaned since the launch day. But hey, nothing a little TLC can fix, right? Next up is the fan. It's held in place by three screws, so I take those out, and before I can fully remove the fan, there's this little white connector that needs to come off. I carefully use pliers holding the connector by the end and the edge, never the cables, you don't want to damage those. Now it's time to tackle the disk drive, but first I have to remove the bottom of the console because there are some more hidden screws. The trick here is to use a sharp tool in this small hole at the bottom of this console. Lift up this plastic notch and turn this whole plastic circle thingy counterclockwise. Once the screws are out, I can lift off the plastic cover, disconnect the cables and pull out the drive. Then I've got two ribbon cables to deal with. These things are delicate, like they bruise if you look at them the wrong way, so I'm extra careful. One needs to be pried open to remove it, while the other one gets to pushed in before it can be unplugged. And then I can peel the ribbon cable all the way back so that I can lift everything out. Lovely dust bunnies, isn't it? This poor console must have been screaming for air. After a quick wipe down on the outside, I remove this rubber band that's wrapped around the internals and start unscrewing more screws to get deeper inside and clean everything properly. If you're doing this at home, take pictures of the screws with your phone or something. Trust me, it will save you a headache later. I obviously did that, because why wouldn't I? Yeah, more on that later. Now, there are some plastic channels that need to be pried open to access the power supply cables. Removing the 8-pin plug from the motherboard can be a pain, especially if you're doing this for the first time, but using a spatula to push in the notch and wiggle it out works the best, in my opinion. I realized later on that this metal bit does not need to come off actually, but it gave me a good chance to wipe down everything properly instead. So, no harm done. After that, I remove this white ribbon cable that connects the PCBs. Both sides of the connector needs to be pushed in before carefully removing the cable. Fitting it through lets me remove the top layer, including the top PCB. Now to remove this metal shield, it basically needs to be pried all around until it gets loose enough to be able to actually lift it. That reveals the four screws holding the heatsink evenly on the other side. And talking about the other side, first I remove all the rest of the screws that holds the complete heatsink itself, and only after that I start removing those four screws I showed earlier, making sure to go in cross pattern and removing the pressure evenly. Now since the thermal paste is bone dry, and because of the thermal pads on the memory chips, it is actually a bit hard to open it up first, but then it reveals the heart of the console itself. And it's time to clean it up and apply some fresh MX thermal paste. Thank you. I actually try to spread the thermopaste so that it covers the whole die and try to make sure that there are no bubbles. The easiest way to do this method is to use a flat tool. It also doesn't need much paste. Basically, the size of a bigger rice grain is enough because after screwing on the heatsink, the pressure itself, it will squeeze it out evenly, even more. And with that, the reassembly can start. By the way, I only noticed how dusty I left some of the PCBs after I rewatched this footage, so that's on me. I pretty much wiped down everything afterwards, but I probably had too bright of an environment, or I just need new glasses, who knows. After screwing back the heatsink, again making sure to go evenly in a cross pattern, back goes the ribbon cable that connects both PCBs, and then again feeding through the hole so that I can place the top half on. Then placing back the plastic tunnel for the cables and this metal plate. By the way, this screw is in the wrong place and you will see in a second why. This is what I meant earlier by taking a photo for the screws, which I obviously took. Yep. Anyhow, basically this screw needs to go in after the power supply is placed back to its place, as you can see it here. Otherwise it's gonna be a bit wonky. And also, after placing back the last metal shield, make sure you screw in all the screws before placing back the small Wi-Fi PCB, because some of them go under that and you won't have enough space to get to it after. Yeah, I definitely didn't do that either. Then I wrap the rubber band back around the power supply and the heatsink, slot everything back into its case, and reattach the disk drive and cables, including the ribbon cables as well. That's a much nicer fan, isn't it? Putting it back doesn't take much effort. I just line it up and it slides right into its place. And then it can be screwed back and plugged back. Taking a picture of the masterwork, Master Chief, is always recommended. And finally, after a couple more wipes, I snap the backplate into place, securing it with a satisfying click. Screws go back in, and that's a wrap. If you find this guide helpful, give it a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.